Hello, I'm Naotika Sogabe. I'm oud, lute, and guitar player and composer. I receive not a few questions about my instruments, and they want to play the similar instruments. I feel really honored that they take my playing as a model. But I'm afraid that they would be disappointed when they finally get a similar instrument and try to play it. The instrument would not sound like my playing, although it has the same quality. If you think about any guitarist or oud player, oh, his instrument sounds good. It's only half the truth. Of course he could have a good instrument and therefore his playing sounds good. But it's also possible that he has an ordinary instrument which you can buy at each music store. But he has such an excellent technique and therefore his playing sounds good. The instrument is indeed important. But you need an appropriate playing technique to create good sound. And now, what is a good sound? Is there some guideline or something like this? It's a subjective impression of listener or yourself if you play the instrument yourself. And of course, there is no guidelines also. We should create sound so that the listener feel it as good sound. It's the listener who decides if the sound is good, and not the player. For better sound, we need the following two techniques. First, technique to get good and various sounds from your instrument. Second, technique to integrate these sounds in your musical expression. The second technique seems to be strange for some of you, but it's very important. The listener recognizes the sound as good only if it's effectively applied in the music. The sound of an instrument is always integrated in a musical expression. Today I'll show you the five steps for the first topic, to get good and various sounds from your instrument. These steps based on physics and modern psychology. Before I continue the topic, I'd like to explain about my lute. My baroque lute is indeed an extraordinary instrument. Most of the good instruments have not only one good sound, but many various sounds. My baroque lute can also create incredibly various sounds. It means the sound changes completely if you attack the strings only a little bit in another angle, pressure, position, and so on. So, because of its great potential, an extraordinary instrument can be very difficult to control, or you can also say to tame. In other words, you can also get various sounds from an ordinary instrument if you master the following techniques. No matter what kind of instrument you have, the following technique is useful for better sound. First step is perceive the sound of the instrument you indeed play. Many people believe to listen the sound they play correctly, but most of them don't do this. In reality, it's not so easy to perceive the sound we indeed create. We need to listen the sound of instrument objectively without any preconception. Mindfulness meditation or vipassana meditation can help us to perceive our environment objectively as it is. Vipassana meditation is a traditional Buddhist meditation. I'm planning to create some videos about meditation technique for musicians. Please be patient. It may take some time to progress our perception. Even if you are not sure if you can listen the sound correctly, you can go to the next step. For the second step, press the strings with finger, pick or reacher and feel the pressure of the strings. This step seems to be ridiculous at first sight, but it's an important training to variate the starting point of vibration of strings. If you attack like this, you have only a few possibilities to influence the vibration of the strings and the whole instrument. In this attack method, the strings begin to vibrate from the zero point, so from the center of the strings. If you press the string, it doesn't begin from the zero point. and it changes the sound, and the strings get more tension at the starting of its vibration. So you can let your instrument to vibrate more effectively. For this technique, we must feel the reaction from the instrument. For the good sound, we should not to command the instrument one-sidedly, but communicate with our instrument. On the third step, press and release the finger, pick or reach out through the string, and listen and feel the sound. Of course, we don't take such a long time for each attack when we play music. This is a training to sharpen our touch sense. If you try this, maybe you realize that the instrument vibrates more and the sound changes. It gets more power. We should not only analyze the sound, but recognize the emotion which the sound causes. The listener feels the sound with their emotion and not only with the rational thought. Music and emotion is a big topic. I'll make some videos about it. On the fourth step, press the strings with another pressure or angle and release your finger, pick or reacher and feel the difference of the sound. If the listener feels, wow, it's a nice sound, the sound is mostly not only one sound, but a combination of various sounds. On the fifth step, try to integrate the sound you created in musical expression. The listener always recognizes the sound together with the musical expression. And when we play music, the sound is not our purpose. To express music, this is the purpose, at least for me. If you integrate the variation of the sounds in your musical expression, your music begins to tell a story. It's a really exciting experience. Thank you for your watching. See you on the next video. Jane.